Welcome one more day to the Tecnodigital School. Lately, I've been asked about how to generate complex geometries in Abaqus to model, for instance, a 3D unit cell of a particle reinforced composite, a short fiber reinforced composite, a woven material, or similar geometries in which we have multiple constituents, like reinforcement and matrix. In today's video, we will be looking at a very powerful set of options that we can apply in the assembly to generate parts with a complex geometry. Boolean operations between instances. In fact, in Abaqus, it would not be possible to generate these kind of parts without these tools. Of course, we could import these complex geometries from somewhere else, but if we can do it right into Abaqus, this will save us lots of headaches, and we can take advantage of the Abaqus scripting capabilities too. So, let's get started. The kind of geometry that we are going to generate looks something like this. We have an instance that represents the matrix, and another instance that represents the reinforcement. In this case, the reinforcement is some sort of ellipsoidal particles. We will start from two parts that I have already prepared. The first is a box-like part from which we will obtain the matrix, and the second one is a particle. So let's go to the assembly. Assembly, let's bring these instances, the bulk and the particle. And here we have them. I will place this particle at the center of this face here. So first I will rotate it around the y-axis. I select two points, 90 degrees. Okay, there it is. And now I will translate it. Translate, instance, done. And I will move it from this point up to the center here. So it will be from 0, 0, 0 up to x is 0, y is 5, and z is 7.5, because this box is 10 by 10 by 15. Enter, and there it is. And finally, we can apply the Boolean operation to create the hole, the gap, of this particle in the matrix. So we go here, click this option, merge cat instances, and we will cut the geometry, we will suppress the original instances, and we will get a new instance called part 1. Continue. The instance to be cut is the bulk, done, and the instance that will make the cut will be only this particle. Done. And there it is. We can see that we have this gap, this hole created from the cut of the particle. And if we go to the assembly, we have a new part, which is this bulk with the gap, and the previous instances as well. They have been suppressed. So we can get this particle back, right-clicking on particle 1, and resume. And there it is. We still have here our particle 1 instance. I will place some more particles very quickly. And here they are. We have three more particles. And we can apply again a Boolean cut with all these new particles at the same time. Go to merge cut, cut geometry, the final part name, I will call it matrix. Suppress original instances and continue. So we select this instance, done. And now we select the instances that will make the cut. So this particle down here, hold shift, this one, and this one. Done. And there it is. We have all of these gaps created by these three particles. So again, we come to the tree, select particle 2, 3, and 4, right click, and resume. And here they are. Now we have the matrix instance with these gaps for the particles and also the particles themselves. Now we need to cut as well the volume of the particles that comes out of the unit cell. So this volume here, there, down there, and up here as well. To do this, we will use another part that I have here. So create instance, and it is dummy one. Okay, this part has a square hole that represents the negative space outside of the unit cell. We will use this part to cut the particles, but before that, we have to merge all the particles to cut them all at the same time. So for that, we also come here to merge cut instances, and now we're going to merge all the particles. So let's say this is all particles. Continue, and we select all the particles. So instances, particle 2, 3, 4, and also particle 1. Okay. So now we have a single instance with all of the particles, and we can select that instance to make the cut. So again, we come to merge cut, cut geometry. The name of this part is going to be particles, because it will be all the particles, including the cut with the dummy instance. Continue. We go to instances and select the all particles instance. This is the instance that we are going to cut. Okay. And now we select the dummy around. Done. And there it is. So we've been able to make the cut of all of the particles at the same time. So in the end, we only have the matrix instance and the particles instance. We could delete all these suppressed instances with delete. Okay. And this as well. Okay. And after each Boolean operation, Abaqus creates a new part. So if we go to the tree, here we have all of the parts. Let's open the particles part. Here we have the final geometry of the particles. So now we can create the mesh, assign sections, etc., etc. And the same for the matrix part, which is this one. These Boolean tools in the assembly are very powerful, and we can obtain really complex geometries like woven textiles, as we can see here. By the way, I generated this geometry of the yarns using TextGen. I will leave a link to TextGen, which is a free open source software, in the blog post. As all what we do in Abaqus, we can take advantage of Python scripts to automate all these operations. I have created a Python script to generate this geometry automatically. So if I go to File, Run Script, Representative Unit Cell Ellipsoids, OK. And we obtain the representative unit cell with some more particles, and it only takes a few seconds now. You can download the script from the blog post. I hope you find it useful, and now come on, put it in practice in your model. It doesn't need to be a representative unit cell or a representative volume element, but you can take advantage of these Boolean operations in many, many more cases. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. And Merry Christmas, by the way. Bye.